Welcome to the Autodesk Face Robot Legacy video series. These are the original videos that Jeff Wilson recorded using Face Robot version 1.5, long before it was integrated into Autodesk Softimage. In these videos, Jeff, who is one of the original designers of Face Robot, focuses on tuning and sculpting the different regions of the face. The workflow shown in these videos is still pretty much the same as it is now, but you might notice a few differences in the interface. For a more up-to-date version of the complete Face Robot workflow, you can check out the 11-part Face Robot series on this channel, which uses the current implementation of Face Robot within Softimage. We hope you enjoy this blast from the past as Jeff displays his mastery of facial animation with Face Robot. In this video, Jeff tunes the chin region, including adjusting the envelope weighting in that area.
And then the last control to really tweak is this chin, and that really just controls kind of that chin pout action. So this one seems to be a little bit touchy by default on a lot of heads, so that one, it's the same process on the regions, but a lot of times it requires quite a tweak on the curve. So if I just put that up into some realistic position there. Then we can crank that up and do the same thing. I think this one actually usually goes the other way. So you might actually have to take this one out further. I think I was going the wrong way there for a while. There we go. Something like that. And that's a really subtle thing too, so you don't need too much of a bulge on that. And again, some of this is a sculpting thing and some of it's enveloping that I'll show you. So you just want to kind of make sure that it's bulging the right amount in the place where you want it to and not worry about, you know, the lumps down here right now. So that gets your controller at least working in the right range now. And then there's the standard kind of painting for that as well. And that really is only a top of the chin kind of effect. So one thing I usually notice about this is it doesn't really, you want that skin to kind of slide around the chin more when it moves up, and right now it kind of doesn't really slide at all. So this is one of those areas where you want to get into the enveloping where there aren't deformers. So it's kind of just like those orbitals and the eyes. You just need to find those lines here, which they're named chin line, so it's fairly obvious. And again, you can go into solo mode and start to kind of see which ones are which. So there's a start offset and end offset, and then the ones in between. So if I start with this one, and I want to get a 180 degree brush to make sure I get it off the lips. And then I'll just paint that back in gradually. Yeah, it's good to paint this one in the pose so you can kind of see the effect. And that one's actually it's pulling it down a little bit, so I don't want it too much on that one. And again, there's a vert there that's 100% weighted into this, but I'm not going to worry about it since the mouth controls that. So that one I want to give some weight, let it bulge. that's the one that's starting to really do some pulling for me. So that's starting to move the verts a little bit for me. So that's a bit heavy. Let's just smooth that out. And I think I'm going to go back and adjust that paint map a little bit more as well. Okay, not perfect, but again, sculpting will finish that one up. At least it feels like it's pulling the skin a little bit from underneath now.